Time to fresh off redneck restorations. This old truck brought to you by elderlyiron.com. You know, if you're out plowing snow, it's pretty good to have some heat in the truck, and I ain't got none.
And here's why.
Disconnection. The standard bypass the heater core because it leaks kind of thing. But I got a new one.
Now on your 67 to 72 Chevrolet trucks, Chevrolet GMC, if you want to get to the heater core, then you have to pull the air plenum off. And to get the air plenum off, you have to remove the inner fender panel. And that's why on some of these you'll find that big hole cut out of here with a torch. So, I'm not going to do that today.
8931.
Oh, great.
Copy 8931 in service.
Hear that sound? That's not good. Okay, maybe I won't cut it out with the torch. Well, if you're wondering why I'm not using air cooler, two reasons. Number one, you don't know if the cage nuts are going to strip out on you behind here. If you just hit it with the impact, then you're done. Get the torch out. Oh, man. This doesn't feel good. It's a fuzz. It's a fuzzy cat. My fuzz. And the other reason is, it's about 20 degrees. It's bad enough hanging on to air tools when it's 40 degrees and your air tool gets down to about 10. Try doing it at 20 degrees. I have a problem. Need these cage nuts stripped out. I am done. Oh. Oh, look out, Fuzzy! Powder's it packing out. It's stripped. Great. Just great. Well, there's always the hope that somebody else has had this off of here before, and I can tell by this bolt here with the extra flat washers on it, it's been off before. Maybe, just maybe, they did us the favor of not putting the nuts on the bottom side. Oh, how to get in here. One's missing. What I'm gonna have to do is grab the camera, point it up in there, and then look at it. Since the camera's a whole lot skinnier than my head, I can just see what I'm looking at. Zooming. Missing. I think that's the first one I already found. That doesn't want to come off. No, it doesn't have to. Let's see, that's got the 5/16 head, that's a straight slot. 5/16, that's a 3/8 head, that's a 7/16 head with built up flat washers. So, I'm guessing. But along with that guess comes the potential reality that they glued it onto the cowl as well. Not drop the nut in the snow. Why, it's falling away. We have a winner. Maybe. Still not enough room to get the core out of there. Put hinges in the way. Well, not such a bad thing if I can pull this off without taking the whole hood off. Thank you.
That was when I was wishing I could use mirror tools. Now, in theory, with this prop in here, it's going to want to go that way. It's a theory. Well, that's not bad at all. Is it going to stay? One thing is holding it up. It'll be a wire of sorts. Why? Yes. The cable. Your front end cable. Of which this heater control is broke. Here we are. Guess I'll have to get rid of all this. Stay. I think maybe this wasn't exactly supposed to be like that.
I'm also getting the feeling that this might be the reason I was getting such paltry airflow out of this thing.
This might also be affecting my airflow. Just a wee bit bigger. Very dangerous thing I'm doing right now. See, the shape of this thing is such that, just like with this side, it tightens up when you bring it in. And it's supposed to securely come around this edge to hold it into the plenum. However, the tanks are just a wee bit bigger on this one than that one. And the distance between the fitting and the core is not exactly what it's supposed to be, which is quite obvious on that heater core. Oh yeah, that's the number. That's the one it calls for. It doesn't have to be exactly like it, now does it? Just because you take the chance of making it leak when you do things like this, especially when you've had this heater core in stock for 10 years. A little tough to return them. By golly, that's just not going to work. I'm literally going to have to flatten this thing out. Modifications. Get us in reasonable proximity on that one. This one's a little tougher.
You see the shape of that wire and how it goes around the tube. That's what I got to do on this side. But this doesn't want to fit. So it doesn't want to go all the way down to start with. Oh, I see. I was putting it back the way they had it installed. Well, what do you know? If I'd installed it the way it's supposed to be installed instead of the way it was in there, it slips on a little better. But this is still an issue.
And I still had to open up the clearance for that to get in there. So I don't feel bad at all. This thing is probably a quarter of an inch too short. This will never do. I can't dent the tank far enough to take up a quarter inch. Of course, this still isn't fully seated on here. Let's see what happens if I can make this fully seated. The problem is trying to seat it is right on a solder joint. I don't like. I can thin this down a little. It's probably where some of that spray foam would be real handy. Put this thing in place and done. Not thin enough. Not enough. Okay. This is not going to work. Why does this always happen to me? Well, if I need to add a quarter of an inch, how shall I do it? With bolt cutters! Maybe if I just bolt that in there, it'll hold it in just fine, like that. I'm thinking maybe so. I was going to take just a little piece of metal and I was going to lay it on there and clamp it in place and put a tack weld on it. But it's really cold. And now that I'm not out in the sun, it's even colder. Yeah, I think I'll just do that. One of the other things I'm going to do, strip caulk. That should help. Let's see, my core is going to go in. Which way is up? That's the top. So I'm going to put strip caulk around this edge. Well, it doesn't work near as good when it's cold. Don't want to stick neither. Maybe I'll give up on that idea. I'd really rather have it on there. But I could put it around the edge of the core just as well. I gotta go find some longer screws. Now the problem with longer screws is that you're on the risk of hooking them into the core. We can't engineer the thing so that the screws don't have a chance of hitting the core. We have to do it so the screws have to be just so. If you ain't got one of them screws, you ain't getting it. Maybe I don't need longer screws. So, on with our next thing. There's a nice little groove around this plenum. It's supposed to have some strip caulk in it. But there isn't any. Until now. I ain't gonna do anything about this. Heater core's not gonna fall out. Time to go back in. Probably put some lube on that. Detent is actually right here, which interferes remarkably with trying to put that screw in or take it out. I get the feeling it's a lot easier to take it off than get it on. So if you loosen the cable strap on the inside, you can pull the cable out just a wee bit more. I could. I'm going to attempt to push that boot down. I don't think I'm going to get very far.
Let's see. I have to crawl inside for the next one. I think what I'll do first is reconnect my hood hinge so as I don't drop it on myself. So, when I pull this off of here, I'm going to get a geyser. So I need to be ready with this hose to put it on there. I think that'll be nice. Plug in the fan. Seems the coolant is low. I haven't had heat in about 10 years with this thing. I want a hot axe. First one I already found. Next one. Still can't get in there. Now I'm also getting a feeling that this might be the reason why there was such paltry airflow. Choke is banging. Thought I fixed all this.